imagine if she got injured and like was out of the second OBI because
I just dropped her on
because she was like, doing a TikTok.
See her who's got fell on the neck.
Hey guys, it's Caps and Eccy on tour, episode 4, and today we're joined by a special guest, Hey Cross.
Nipped back.
It's great to have you on, okay? I'm getting bored of her now.
That's a bit harsh.
Savage.
How are we feeling after the game, okay?
I've not slept a great deal. you don't know what this is like.
Well,
you know more for what the batting is like. But you'll get this. You get used to bowling and taking wickets, but scoring runs is not like our thing.
Like, we bowl and then we're like, oh, we'll have some lunch and we'll sit down. I don't think about it.
Yeah, so I think the adrenaline was like sky high for 2 days. And then it rained all day yesterday, and that really just brought me back down to earth.
We did have a bit of a nightmare the other day because Capsey doesn't eat before she bats, and we were at lunch, and Louie's coming and gone, just letting you know Capsey's going to go at three every little wicket in the power play, as she scoffed a massive plate of noodles and pasta.
You only found that out
on Friday. So like, I never eat before I go out to bat because I just get too nervous and I feel awful. Like, I just can't eat. And then I was like, oh, I'm bagging at 5 or 6. I could actually have lunch.
Beat up,
all of that. I was eating carbonara, so
I
just finished like my last mouthful. And then Louis comes up and he's like, oh yeah, if you lose a wicket in the power play, you're batting at 3.
Right.
And honestly, I felt so ill.
I mean, it worked.
What have you been up to outside of cricket?
Played a little bit of golf.
How's it going for you?
Not good. Not really all that good. But I like it. I'm invested. I bought a driver. Went and had a driver fit in, bought a driver. I lost my golf hat, so now I feel like I've got the driver, but not got the hat.
I don't mean to be nosy, because I'm getting the course set up. I was going for your bag, it said, is that irons in there?
Yeah, there is. I've got a 7. I only use a 7, to be fair.
So where's your 5?
So they're not my clubs, I'm being
right. Where are they?
Well, if they're not in there, they've been stolen, and this is now worrying me. And we've got another 7 minutes to fill before I start thinking about my golf stuff and where they are.
We're playing golf for an hour.
Yeah, we are. But other than that, we had a really great night in London, didn't we? We celebrated the T20 series. That was fun times.
We weren't there, were we?
Oh, you did Silverstone?
Yeah, we were at Silverstone.
Yeah, you missed the night out.
Yeah.
Okay, we won't talk about that then. It was rubbish.
Why was the bus so about telling me? Tired.
Not much sleep the night before, yeah. We won a T20 series against Australia though, so it was worth it.
It was quite nice actually because on that day off, people go to Wimbledon, we went to Silverstone. It looked like everyone just got to different events.
Yeah,
and we
everyone...
loved Silverstone, didn't we?
Oh, it was so cool. Crossy, we can't go too far past the heroics.
When you walk off that field, how did you feel?
Off after we'd won?
Yeah.
A lot of relief. a lot of relief. Yeah.
Do you know what I had days off about? When I had my eyes closed in that test match, when I was looking at that test match.
I love how all my teammates have so much faith in my batting that they shut their eyes when I'm playing.
No, I don't. I didn't do it yesterday, but I have five players like, oh, here we go again.
I think the thing that got me through the whole innings, every time I thought about trying to score runs, I was like, Lauren Bell is next. We cannot allow Lauren Bell to come out into this situation.
That's because she has to run, walk, jump, yeah, so she does.
Belly gets really, what's the right word? Conscious of how she walks out when she's batting. And she thinks about the walkout more than the batting. So I was like, let's just not put her through that. And that actually got me and Heather through it. But Hev was so calm. Hev was like, let's just get it down to 20, because I think it was 29 when I went out. Then she was like, when we got to that, get it down to 10. Then we got it down to 10, she's like, right, 5 now. And then we got it down to 5, and she was like, should we win it? So we're like, we'll try and win it.
That is mad.
It has been amazing though. Like, I've never known people get so behind an England women's cricket team in the UK. Like, it's been mega. I saw a stat the other day that you were 12 years old when we last won a T20 series against Australia.
What year would I be in? 12 years old?
2017?
I'd have been in year 7.
Oh gosh.
It's alright.
Oh, anyway, let's talk about your catch.
To be honest, I wasn't ready for the ball.
You were still putting your
cap on. I was still putting my cap on. And then I just ran at it. And I was so far in the ring. I just went outside the ring.
You also didn't jump.
I did jump a little bit.
You do go. There is a picture.
And they pulled me side out
now. We don't need that.
It's a great picture of you just like one-handed hooking it.
I'm in a really rogue position now. No, I am buzzed for it. Really, I was very shocked that Cord was just stopped.
I think we all were.
You did the shoot. You did the shoot. Yeah. Yeah.
Must be like. And Tammy came over and went, I love that.
Gave it back.
Cheers, mate.
What a weird thing to do in that moment.
It's just to the boat. I was like,
we do things like that though, because in amongst all the celebrations at the end of Bristol, someone came up to me, I don't know who it is, pats me on the back and goes, oh, you didn't have your GPS in Capsey. And I was like, in this moment, that's what you're worried about. Like, Dave's going to be bothered that innings isn't on the GPS data now. I don't know who it was, I need to find that out.
Very Wongy.
Probably
it might be Wongy. Yeah, it might have been Wongy. Great day though, loved it.
So I've done the trend, but we're all TikTokers now.
Yeah.
You started it, I reckon. Bailey's also on it. Glennie's always been a TikToker.
Glennie's wild on TikTok. Like, she's... I don't know how she finds time to do cricket, do all the hair and makeup, look pristine every single day, and TikTok.
Well, TikToks will take a long time.
That's what I mean. Where are these hours?
Well, that Zara one you showed me today, that must have took like a good half an hour, 45 minutes.
But she's very good. But yeah, I got told I needed to have it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm more marketable apparently if I've got TikTok, so...
Oh, right, here we go.
And
watch
then,
the space.
Watch the space.
Yeah, if you want a Zara deal, then come to me, I don't know. So, yeah, and then everyone's like, jump on it, and now I'm having three dances in the dressing room, and it's quite embarrassing.
We need to get Heaven out on the dance.
I think you can do that easily.
Oh, I'm not sure.
I think
you can. I reckon you can. She was watching, and even though she's taking the mic out of you, I reckon you can get it.
Okay. You should get people to send you the video that they want to see Heather in, like suggestions for Heather and I dancing on TikTok.
I wonder what they'd send. Justin Bieber or something like that, if you want to.
I mean, you had belly upside down underneath your legs the other day. Like, what was
you
that?
You were helpless,
I
swear.
I was trying to work, like, they were doing it, like, they just couldn't work it out. And, like, it took forever just to work out how to get belly upside down.
Well, once we got it, we got to put belly's head. She got up most times, she was crying.
Imagine if she got injured and, like, was out of the second ODI.
Yeah. I just dropped her on
because she'd be doing a TikTok.
See, and it's got fell on the neck.
Yeah, maybe it shouldn't matter. Yeah.
We made it through. No one was injured in the process of TikToking.
It's been amazing to kind of see how much everyone's getting behind it.
Kate definitely got some love.
My phone blew up the other day. I think it's because it was such a shock for everyone. My mum thought I was going to get a first ball as well. She told my dad I was going to be out first ball.
That's nice.
I know. She didn't break my life. But no, the support has been incredible.
I feel like everyone's watching it back, like, when I come back home, like, everyone's watching the games. Tracy and Deb's watching the games, everyone's watching the games.
As long as Tracy and Deb's watching
the games.
People who don't watch cricket are watching it.
Yeah. I got a really, really cute message yesterday on Instagram from a little girl who's going to play one of her first cricket games, and she was really nervous, and she listened to mine and Al's podcast on the way there. And then she got out of the car and she was like, right, I'm going to go back like posse. And like her mum was like, she just had this little skip in her, like, yeah, a little bit of confidence. And I was like, that's so cute.
That is so cute.
That's what it's all about, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's fine next year.
Yeah.
Kate Cross is doing that.
Very good.
It's
good.
Thank you very much for watching the Captain Eccy on Tour series. This is the last one before we go to India later on in the year. Thank you so much, Kate Cross, for joining us for our last episode. And thank you to Capsey. Couldn't do it without you.
Thanks, so that's the last thing you've ever said.
See you all soon.